Hi, I'm Nathan, Certified Beer Sommelier at Beerwulf. One of the things I like most as a beer sommelier is helping beer drinkers to discover the great variety of beer and surprise you with all the beautiful flavors that beer has to offer. And the best way to discover beer and its full glory is a beer tasting. In this video, I'll explain in 5 steps how to organize your beer tasting at home. First, we're gonna choose the beers. And with this, there's no real right or wrong when it comes to beer tasting, because you can, of course, taste every beer that's around the world. But you want to keep it a little bit more interesting, so I recommend a variation of beer styles, and in that way, you discover the variety of beer itself. So go for a blonde, maybe a stout, Belgian double. There are hundreds of beer styles, and the more variety you have, the more you can discover, of course. Another option is a themed beer tasting. In that case, you take several beers from a certain country or a region, or not a variety of beer styles, but all the same beer styles, like taste 4 different types of IPA, 4 stouts, and go more in depth of that specific beer style. Another option is take 4 different beers of one brewer. Take 4 beers of Lagunitas, 4 beers of Beavertown, 4 beers of whatever your favorite brewer is, and discover this specific brewer. All of our mixed cases are suitable to select beers for beer tasting. Our brewer cases as well, and then you discover beers from one brewery. How many beers do I need? What a lot of beer drinkers overestimate is the amount of beers to taste. A maximum in the end is 6 beers you can taste. And it's not only about the amount of alcohol, that's also the amount of flavors your taste buds can handle. So first, the amount of alcohol. After a certain amount, you will get sloppy. And then you won't be able to taste beer properly anymore. So for instance, a 2-person tasting, you choose 4 beers and then you split the beers with the 2 of you. With a 3-person tasting, you go for 6 beers and then you split the beers with the 3 of you, of course. When you're tasting alone, choose 2, maximum 3 beers, and well, then it's enough for a proper beer tasting. So the golden rule here is go for maximum 6 different beers, which is not just about the alcohol, it's also the amount of flavors you and your taste buds can handle. Step 3, the preparation. Make sure you have proper glassware. Suitable glasses for beer tasting is something like our brand new Beerwulf glass. This is a good example of a tasting glass. This balloon-shaped glass. This is a teku, great for beer tasting. Make sure you take a glass, you grab a glass that is in this kind of form. If you don't have a glass like that, don't go for just a regular pint glass or whatever, then go for a wine glass. This is also perfect for beer tasting. Next to glass, you need water, because in between the beers, you want to clean your palate, and water is ideal for that. Serving temperature, one of the most asked questions about beer tastings is what is actually the right serving temperature? The golden rule here is that the amount of alcohol, that is the serving temperature in degrees Celsius. A lot of brewers also put the serving temperature on a bottle, but when it goes for beer tasting, you might want to start around that temperature or even a little bit higher. So in general, with a beer tasting, especially when you have like 4, well, up to 6 beers, it's okay to grab all the beers from your fridge and just put it outside of the fridge, because the last beer most of the time is a little bit higher in alcohol, so well, then it has time to warm up a bit, and then it's great as the last beer to discover it at its best at the right temperature. And last but not least, making notes. Your ability to taste is what you have, but describing the variety of flavors, that is something you can train, and a tasting form is very helpful for that. This form you can find on our website. The link is below in the video description. And you know, this is the form to make notes during your beer tasting. 4, the order of tasting. So you received your pack with beer. You selected 4 beers for your tasting, but what is the right order to taste them? What you want to do is build up in intensity. So you start with the least intense beer and end with the most intense beer, the most flavorful beer. But how to determine the intensity of beer? The first step what you can do is take the amount of alcohol. So you start with the lowest ABV one and end with the highest. So in this case, we have a Palane Weizen 5.5%. This is a stout, 6%. This blonde is 6.5%. And this quadruple rum from La Trappe is 10%. And there we have a pretty good tasting order. Another thing that determines the intensity of beer is the color. So blonde goes before darker beers. In this case, we have two beers with more or less a similar, with the same amount of alcohol. This stout 6% and this blonde 6.5%. So what we do now, this is a stout, dark brown, almost black beer, and this is a blonde, so we swap these. This is a little bit more intense. The difference between 6% and 10%, a lot of people think is a stout that's a really intense beer. It is, but a 6% stout can be maybe a little bit refreshing, up to you to decide. But the 6% stout goes before this 10% amber colored quadruple. Step 5, the important part, this is the actual tasting. And we're gonna do that in 4 steps. We're gonna look, smell, taste, and swallow. Very important with beer. So there we go. 1. Look at the beer. You want to see the color. In this case, it's brown, red. It's pretty red, actually. Orange, almost. Try to describe the flavors. Not my strongest point, to be honest. I always say that I'm a beer sommelier, not a painter. But our tasting form can help you there, because there is a lot of color. You can, well, see what color the beer is. Look at the foam. What's the size of the bubbles? What's the color of the foam? Is it really white, or is it a little bit off-white, sometimes brown or even pink? In this case, I see a beautiful red, brown beer, off-white, layer of foam, pretty firm layer of foam, different bubble sizes, looks good. 2, smell. Smelling beer is really important because you have the 5 basic taste elements, which is sweet, sour, salty, bitter, and umami. And that's what you taste, and the rest is actually aroma. When you take a sip, you will detect the aroma as well, because aroma, you get that through your nose, to be more precise, your nasal cavity. Don't start with just stick your nose in there. Start a little bit here and get the first glimpse of the aroma. It might be a little bit different when you just dig in there, and in the end you're gonna dig in and smell what the beer is about. In this case, it's fruity. With caramel, smells good. Step 3, there we go, the actual tasting. For the basic taste elements, then the aroma and the mouthfeel. And combining that is the actual flavor. You're allowed to make disgusting sounds. When you do this, you will notice this does something to the beer. You add oxygen, and releasing more flavors, actually, and you taste it really well then. That brings us to the last step of beer tasting, swallow. There we go. Swallow important for, of course, the finish and the aftertaste, what comes after the finish. And unlike wine, to get the full flavor experience with beer, you have to swallow it. So that's what to do. That's how to organize a beer tasting at home. Make sure you have fun and enjoy it responsibly. I hope you enjoyed this video, and make sure to like and subscribe to our channel. If you want to learn more about beer or find your next favorite beer, then head to beerwulf.com. Cheers.